It's taken nearly 90 years to bring you these pictures. At 9:30 this morning, the outside world finally saw the inside of the Court of Appeal.
Lords, I will take the facts as read.
First up, Alastair Cameron QC, brother of the Prime Minister. He was appealing one man's seven-year sentence for making counterfeit pound coins. But Lord Justice Pitchford rejected the request.
The application must be refused.
The decision to televise these proceedings has been welcomed by major broadcasters, senior judges, and one of Britain's best-known barristers.
You can walk in this building, a member of the public can, the media are allowed to go in already. The problem is obviously getting the way in which the court works out to a bigger public. And what's the best way of doing that? I think it's with having cameras in there, and eventually it'll become, you know, daily bread. People won't even notice it's there.
Inside these late 19th century courtrooms, some 21st century technology.
This landmark moment brings access to the justice system like never before, but there are strict rules. The cameras can't show anything other than the three judges and the lawyers in the courtroom. So it means that the dock and the person sitting in it won't be shown on TV.
Court TV has long been a staple of broadcasting in other countries. The high-profile trials of Louise Woodward, Amanda Knox, and most notably, O.J. Simpson.
Not guilty of the crime of murder.
Critics condemned the coverage as sensationalist, but could we eventually see the same here?
This is not going to be American-style O.J. Simpson's type of cases. That is where everybody gets filmed, anything that happens in the courtroom. That's not going to be the case here.
Cameras are still forbidden from magistrates and crown courts in England and Wales. But many legal commentators believe the future will see more cameras going into more courts. Julian Drucker, 5 News.